Me and my voice. Okay. Okay. Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Piyawan Jiayusakamon. I am a master degree student from Aesthetic, Restorative and Implant Surgery program from Chulalongkorn University. And the topic that I'm going to present today is an in vitro pilot study compare volumetric change of dental implant in the titanium abutment and zirconate abutment after circular. Let me explain about why do we need to concern to the implant and abutment connection. The implant abutment connection interface is a key feature to consider when choosing an implant system. It is the location of the implant bodies connect to the abutment and restoration. The two important things to think about are mechanical and biological factors. Even though these things are being to talk about separately, it should be clear that there is a strong connection between them. For the mechanical factors, a tight and a high quality bond between the joint component are the most consideration factors, and also material, manufacturing, machining tolerance, and quality of the matching part too. When the two surfaces of material will connect and receive the load, where of the connection interface might be happen due to how much of the micro motion will perform. The result of where can be induced the screw loosening, screw fracture, the abutment fracture, and also dental implant fracture. For the biological factors, microbiological contamination of the implant interior surface, which can serve as a reservoir for the bacteria. A poor connection would not provide an adequate seal against ingest of bacteria, which in turn could lead to the peri-implant disease or implant loss. Biocompatibility and material selection also need to carefully consider compared to the use of other material contacting the peri-implant soft tissue. Zirconia and titanium provide excellent biocompatibility and have shown superior biological response. Nowadays, things are different. It's becoming more and more popular for the people who are concerned about aesthetic smile. Titanium dental implant have been used a lot because they are good at both biological and mechanical things. However, the grayish gingival discoloration caused by titanium is an issue, especially in the patient with the thin gingival biotype or high smile line. To fulfill the increasing of demand of optimal aesthetic and this disadvantage, the different color abutment have been used to enhance the light reflection through the gingival area. Zirconia abutment will say to have a lot of good things about them, like less of plaque and shorter probing depth than the titanium abutment. Zirconia has been shown to more gentle to the tissue around the implant than the titanium because it doesn't cause of much inflammation, but the zirconia abutment still have their limitation. Further, it is not clear if the titanium particle that have been shaved off the implant interface can move from the interface to the soft tissue and make the tattoo of the titanium particle in the peri-implant gingival. Many previous research had looked at the mechanical feature of the implant and abutment connection, but it hasn't focused on the volume loss of the dental implant that occur in the oral cavity. And this is why this study could be useful. For the objective of this study, to compare of the volumetric change of the dental implant of to the two different abutment material after psychic load. This is the material risk that I used in this study. I used the bone level titanium implant with diameter 4.1 millimeter from the storeman and titanium abutment, which is a vario based type, and the zirconia abutment, it's a CAD abutment. And I use the universal testing machine for the psychic load. And I measure the volumetric of dental implant with the true density analyzer. Methodology. And overall, the total of 14 dental implants were utilized during this procedure. In this study, 7 dental implants were utilized with the titanium abutment, which is a good one. And the 7 dental implants were used with the zirconia abutment, which is a group 2. Gas sphygmotomy were utilized to determine the volume of the titanium implant before load. After that, the sample were subject to cyclic loading for 1 million cycle. And the gas sphygmotomy analyzer were used to measure the post-load volume after we loaded. Statistic analysis. The Shapiro wheel analysis were performed to determine the data normal distribution. The uniformity of variant was determined using leaf-in test. The independent t-test was performed to compare the percent volume loss of the two different abutment types. The statistic analysis was performed by using SPSS program, and a p-value of less than 0.05 was considered statistically significant. The result, during the cyclic loading, no implant fracture or abutment fracture was found in my study. For the post-load volume, there was no significant difference in post-load volume between two groups. For the volume loss, there was no significant difference between volume loss between the two groups. And for the percent volume loss, there also no significant difference in percent volume loss between two groups. And after cyclic load, zirconia abutment revealed some particle of the titanium at the connection as I shown in the picture. And because of the sample peak load value was so little, you can see that when I convert to the percent, the outcome was a large fracture. Move to the discussion. When I comparing the peak load and post load volume of titanium implant connect to zirconia and titanium abutment, there is no difference in volume loss between the two material. But in vitro testing has limitation because of the difficult in simulate or clinical variable, and ISO standard was created in order to standardize dental implant using mechanical cycling. For the mode of failure of the dental abutment, the current real-world investigation determined the mode of failure for zirconia and titanium abutment. Found the most common of mode of failure for zirconia was screw deformation, and for the titanium abutment, it was a deformation of assembly component, either the abutment or screw. The study from Stimmelmet et al. Comparing the SDM micrograph before and after cyclic loading, more wear and damage on the implant interface was recorded when connected to the zirconia abutment compared to titanium abutment. Only minimal wear or abrasion was found on the SCM image of the cramp groove load with the titanium abutment, as you can see in the picture. Zirconia has the higher modulus of elastic than the titanium. However, when the different materials are connected, more wear should occur at the lower Young modulus material. Gas sphygmotomy. This technique uses the gas displacement method to measure the volume accuracy. In the gas that I use in this study is a helium. This technique is not time consuming because it only determines the final quantity of total volume. But for the precise result, the volumetric change should calibrate by other techniques. Limitation of this study. The study does not take into account other aspects such as amplitude, direction of the force, duration of the force, the composition of the saliva, or the pH of the saliva. The level of volumetric loss at the titanium abutment contact can be influenced by a variety of factors. For the conclusion, the implant with the zirconia abutment show the same length, of loss and wear as an implant with titanium abutment after psychic load. The clinical consequences of discovery are unknown at this time. However, the risk of component losing and eventually fracture, as well as the release of particle titanium debris, could be cause of concern. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Dr. Pia Wan, for your nice presentation.
Thank you.
Is there any question from the audience? So we have 18 participants now. Okay. It's very interesting for this research. But I have some question about the cyclic loading. I'm not understand clearly that what is the on top or what is like the crown or restoration on the abutment. What did you used for this one?
For my research, I did not use any abutment or any crown or any top of the abutment. I use just only the abutment, pure abutment. Yeah, because I try to exclude the many factor, for example, like cement or especially in cement.
Uh-huh.
Okay. I focus so, just only the volume loss in the implant.
And how does it loss? I mean that the volume loss. I understand that it should be some contact or something that make the abutment abrasive,
yes.
Right? This abrasion that make the volume loss, but if you have not any crown or something on the top, how does this loss?
Oh, I don't have any crown on the top, but I have like the machine have. Like I load directly to the abutment.
Uh-huh, okay.
Yeah.
So you mean that the contact between the holder
from the cyclic the machine and abutment.
The machine holder and abutment. Okay, I see. So that it lost very little, yeah. Right? Uh-huh.
It might be because it normally when the implant in place in the patient, it have many factor like saliva or many factor of the patient.
Uh-huh,
I think
so.
If in the clinical might be lost than this.
And in the both group for the specimen, for the zirconium, is there any sign of fracture or any sign of the any breakdown or something on the zirconium abutment?
I didn't see any fracture or any sign of abutment for zirconium abutment, and also in titanium. It might be because of the force that I load on the abutment. I use like 100 newton and 15 hertz. It's kind of like normal chewing.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it's mimic like a normal chewing.
Okay, you did the 1 million load cycle,
yeah.
Right? It's about 4 or 5 year periods.
Yes.
Okay. So that means the zirconium abutment that it should be used as the titanium abutment, right? And have the aesthetic advantage.
Should be used, but the limitation of zirconia is still have like if we use in the small diameter, it might be create some crack or it formed my review. In the small diameter of the zirconia abutment can show the crack or fracture. So if you want to use the zirconia or titanium zirconia abutment on the anterior area, you have to like choose and focus. Like you, if you use the small diameter of implant and you use the zirconia department. Mm-hmm. So it might be concerned about this thing because mm-hmm. in my study, I am not compare the large diameter and small diameter.
Mm-hmm. Okay. For your next research, next project, you can do this one. So you have new project already. Okay. Thank you very much, Dr. Thank Piawan.
You. Nice
Thank
to meet
you for your nice presentation. Very, very, very good. Okay.
I really appreciate to come here again.
Thank you.